Good morning, everybody at Fellowship Church. How y'all doing this morning? So glad you're here. Thank you so much for being here. If you're out there in the foyer, come on in the house, folks. We're getting started. We have some incredible music this morning. Mitchell's been going down memory lane a bit with Joel and some of the other guys and talking about music that they've done in the past, because it's coming on like 9-10 years that Mitchell and Joel have been singing up here on stage together along with Chris. And of course, you know, Brian and Rod, and Miss Karen's been here forever. Like, she's almost stapled to the chair, but she's been here forever. And it's been incredible to see Saltwater Worship evolve into Saltwater Worship. And today they're going to look back at some of their older songs, at the first songs that they ever had done together. First service, if you weren't here, you missed out on a great, great sermon on the prodigal son. Joel came forward with a great message going over three different parables and how they all tie together. And I suggest you check it out online, watch it on Facebook, watch it on YouTube. It's incredible. Really, really great message. But you all are so very blessed this morning. Christopher Brooks is going to be giving you a message this morning on love, on how we need it, how we need to show it, all of those different things. We all need help with it because, man, oh, man, it's easy to love lovable people. It's easy to love people we already love. But, man, we're called to love people that are pretty unlikable. So we're going to get some help in that department this morning. I got scared because that was dark as anything. I thought the screen had gone away again. So we had a great, great morning. If you don't mind, let's jump to our feet. We're going to do one song, and then we're going to give you a break. And then we're going to do three songs in a row later. We got incredible music lined up again, like I said. And we still got some folks coming in from outside. Saltwater, we love and appreciate you. Thank you so much. Y'all are in for a treat. We're going to praise the Lord together. And we always like to say it here. We thank God we live in America because we're able to worship here freely. Standing on the scriptures, say what the scriptures say, and believe what the scriptures teach. And a lot of places you can go to prison for that. So pray for our country. Amen. We love you and appreciate you.
Thank you, Alex. How's everyone doing this morning? Good. We got a little bit of a different day. My dad's out of town in North Carolina. So got Chris is speaking this service. Joel spoke last service. But Chris, 2014. So it's been 10 years since me and Chris have been playing together. So a long time. And it's been a fun ride. And we're still all brothers, all of us here. We're all brothers. We all came together. Well, that's like a father almost, but. Yeah, big brother, all right. Older brother. But we're gonna reach back into our pockets and pick up some older songs that we did. This is a Jesus Culture song called Your Love Never Fails. And we're going to just start singing. So let's go.
Can't separate, even if I ran away, 'cause your love never fails. I know I still make mistakes, but you have your mercies for me every day. Your love never fails. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes in the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Oh, your love never fails. The wind is strong, I'm not alone here in these open seas. Your love never fails. Ooh. The chasm is far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. Your love never fails.
Awesome. Thank you so much. What a great promise that is, isn't it? No matter what you're going through, no matter how tough things are, no matter how good things are, God's going to take those things and use them together for His good, for your good. We may not see the good here always. We may not see how it pans out. But on the other side, I think we get that perspective where we can see how our suffering can affect other people in different ways. People see us suffer, and they wonder how we do it, how we make it. And even like sometimes we look at ourselves and like, I'm not making it. I'm falling apart. But the outside world might be looking at you and going, wow, how are they holding it together? What is this Jesus thing all about? You may have an influence on someone's eternity through your suffering. So, well, it's just an incredible promise. It's a promise that we need to hold on to tight with both hands. Let's go ahead and pray, and then I will let you all sit down. Morning, guys. Got a little newborn coming in. Let's pray. Father God, we humbly come to you this morning, so thankful for an incredible first service. And Lord, we pray, Lord, that the second service is equally as a sweet-smelling incense to you, Lord. You promise, another promise that you make is that you're with us when two or more are gathered, Lord. And there's much more than two in this room today gathered in your name. So we can have confidence that you're here with us this morning, Lord. May we feel you. May we know you're here with us. May we trust in you that you're here, Lord. And Lord, may everything we do here be an honoring thing to you. And Lord, touch our hearts if it's not. Help us to be the best we can be, to be the salt and light we're called to be, Lord. And Lord, we love you. We love you so very much. And everything we have and everything we do, we do in an attempt to honor you. And Lord, when we stray from that, help us to get back close to you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We say this in your holy name. Amen. God bless you all. Please sit down. Thank you so much. Once again, I said, Pastor Gary is out of town this week. He's up in North Carolina with Kim. He'll be back next week continuing his series on the end times, Book of Revelation, all that stuff in the scriptures that we're also interested in right now because the news is going crazy. But it's going to be a great series. He'll be continuing it next week. Today, though, we have something really encouraging with Chris coming up and talking about love, talking about the need for love, the importance of love, and why it's considered the greatest gift, really. All those other gifts that we see in Scripture, they pale in comparison to love. So we're super excited to hear Chris talk about it this morning. If you've never heard Chris speak, you're in for a treat. So again, we thank you for being here. We have some announcements now, if you don't mind paying a little bit of time with me. I'll try to go through them as quick as possible. We have new visitors every week, and we're so grateful when you come out. If you don't mind filling out these guest registries that are right there in that worship guide that you got when you walked in the door, or you can go out to the Welcome Center and fill out the same basic info out there. We promise we're not going to bother you. We're not going to come knock on your door or anything like that. We just want to send you a note of thanks for being here this week and a postcard whenever a big event is going on. And the cool thing is if you go out to that Welcome Center, they'll give you a little gift bag with some sunglasses, all kinds of cool stuff in there about the church. And if you have little ones with you, go over there too because Ms. Dina came up with a great idea of having little bags for the kids too. So go on over there. If today's your first time here and just, you know, we want to be a blessing to you and let you know how much we love and appreciate you. Watch FC Live is on the internet every single Sunday while we're on stage. I'm messing up my words. Good morning, by the way, everyone online. Thank you so much for tuning in with us. Do us a favor. Go ahead and bookmark this on whatever device you're using, just because like last week, Facebook went crazy on us again. You can always go to watchfclive.com and tune in live to the broadcast here of the church service. So thank you so much for tuning in. Send us a Facebook message or an email, and we will send you the same basic info that we just spoke about for everybody who's here live in the room today. Lots of Bible studies going on here at Fellowship Church. We encourage you to plug into one. If you haven't yet, check them out right there in your worship guide. Give us a call at the office if you have any questions about any of them, and we'll fill you in. Friend to Friend every Tuesday for folks that want to make some new friends here at the church. Come on out. They play board games. They eat together. But more importantly than anything, they become friends, and they go out for lunch, and it's a really, really great get-together time every single Tuesday right here at the church at 1 o'clock. And Fellowship Recovery meets every single Wednesday right here at Fellowship Church. We encourage you to come on out at 5:45 for an incredible meal that's out there in the foyer prepared for you by people that love you. It's all for free before they come in here for the music, time in God's Word, testimony time. And this is all about you getting as close to Jesus as possible so you can overcome any hurts, any habits, any struggles you might be having. And we all have those. So we come on out on a Wednesday for a great, great Wednesday night service. And for anybody who's been struggling with grief and the loss of a loved one, we encourage you to come out on a Wednesday also at 4 o'clock to come along other folks that are going through similar situations who have lost a loved one. It may be recent. It may be many, many years ago, but they're still hurting. They want to come alongside you. They want to love you. They want to encourage you and let you know that you're not going crazy with your emotions, that you don't have to go through this all alone. So come on a Wednesday for a great Wednesday night group meeting at 4 o'clock. This is also really big, please. On Freedom Celebration Sunday is next Sunday, the last Sunday of the month. I encourage you all to please make no other lunch plans. Plan on being here right after the service. We're going to have on the grounds fried chicken from Publix. We're going to be doing potato salad, coleslaw. Larry's going to be doing his green beans, which is bacon with smatters of green beans added to it, and it's just amazing, amazing food. We're going to be providing dessert. You don't have to provide a thing. Bring a thing that day, just yourselves. We're going to be celebrating America with Memorial Day coming up, and we just encourage you to sign up, though, on your way out today so we have enough food for everybody. So please, out here to the right, sign up on your way out. And then on the last Wednesday of the month, a week from this Wednesday, The Mission, Sherry's band, is going to be on the stage during Fellowship Recovery doing a concert at 6:30. So please come on out. Come at 5:45 for the meal and then stay for the concert a week from Wednesday. Men's prayer breakfast is going to be at Stefano's, guys. Not the first Saturday of the month next month, but the second one. We're going to be meeting at Stefano's. The church is going to be picking up the tab that day. We're going to be paying for everyone's breakfast. We ask you to bring a couple of bucks worth of cash so that we can be a blessing to the waitress. Really tip her to death because it's everything's going down. Restaurants are slowing down. Everything's slowing down now. Season's about over, and folks could use a little bit of extra help. So we like to be a real big blessing to the staff anywhere we go, especially in the church's name, that we want to be a good representation out there in the community. But guys, we ask you to sign up for this on the way out today, so we have enough, so we can make a head count and properly let them know for the reservation how many seats we need. That'll be on the 8th of June. Talk Truth, Pastor Gary's on the radio nearly every day of the week. Check him out on 91.3 on the FM. That is a local Christian radio station that Roger also works at. And he does all the programming and anything technical that happens. If it's on the air, it's working, he's done it. And if it's not, lightning did that. It's true. So this is our town. We thank you so much for wearing the shirts, putting those hats on your head. It means the world to us. Thank you for being a part of someone's testimony and directing them here to the church. People see those ovals. I see the ovals everywhere. I'm sure you do too. People may not be searching for a church, but when they are, they're going to be like, what about that oval church? What about that red oval church? You just never know what an impact that makes, what a seed it plants by putting a bumper sticker on your car or wearing a shirt out and about in the community. So please help us be a part of someone's testimony. Get them here to the church so that Pastor Gary can tell them about Jesus. Everything's about $5 out there. We'd love for you to grab them. Ladies, we have the V-necks are back in stock with all different colors and some different sizes. We'd love for you to check them out today as well. Give2fc.com, super easy way to give online. We thank you for your giving here, Fellowship Church. We're a debt-free ministry because of you. Super easy way to give a one-time, weekly, monthly gift. And, of course, you can text right from your phone once you set that up. And that P.O. box, all you folks watching from up north, we thank you so much for filling that box with notes of encouragement. Many of you give that way as well, but please make sure you stay in touch with us. It means everything to us that we know you're coming back in a few months. We love and appreciate you guys. We're going to bring Saltwater back out for 3 more songs. Y'all can stay seated. There's 2 amazing songs that they're going to come out and do now. It's really, really heart-touching, heartwarming. It'll get you in the right spirit. It's an incredible way to start your week and start your worship this morning with Saltwater this morning. So let's give them a round of applause if you don't mind. We love and appreciate y'all. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Alex. Thank you, thank you. So Chris has been here 10 years. Joel has been here 9. It's got to be 9. Yeah. And this next song we're going to do was the very first. Actually, before Joel came, he sat right there, about 6 rows back. My dad brought him down to me, and he was like, hey, this boy can sing. So we tried him out on this song right here called My Story by Big Daddy Weave.
If I told you my story, you would hear hope and wouldn't let go. If I told you my story, you would hear love and never give up. If I told you my story, you would hear life, but it wasn't mine. Oh, if I should speak and let it be of the grace that is greater than all my sin, but when just and where mercy wins of the kind told you my story, you would hear victory over the enemy. If I told you my story, you would hear freedom that was won for me. If I told you my story, you would hear life overcome the grave. If I should speak, then let it be of the grace that is greater than all my sin, of when justice would serve.
Next song we're going to do, first of all, Joel, said it first service, say it again, your voice is just phenomenal. You've just come so far in these last 9 years. Just absolutely, it's been awesome. This whole team, though, Chris, you're a big part of this team as well, man. Love your energy separating me and Joel's quiet normally. It's nice. It's good.
It's nice to add Sherry to that in here, too.
Yeah, it's a good contrast right there. So.
Yeah, for sure.
But this, me and Joel started doing songs by this male duo called Shane and Shane. They do a lot of hymns and worship songs. And I think this is one of the first ones that we did. I'm pretty sure it was like one of the very first ones that we did. It's called Scandal of Grace. You got anything to say, Chris?
Now, these guys hit some of the craziest harmonies. I thought y'all were out of your mind trying to do Shane and Shane songs, but yeah. The fact that you guys can pull it off has been very impressive. I'm just blessed to be a part of you guys.
We're blessed to have you, man. Appreciate it. Love all you guys.
Makes sense of it all. scandal of grace, you died in my place, my soul will live. Oh, to be like you, give all I have just to know you. Jesus, there's no one beside you. Forever.
Before put old Christopher here on the stage, we've got one more song. I'm going to have you stand up with us. If
you don't. You know, we spend a lot of time when we're preparing these songs for worship. A lot of times there'll be a song that'll come up, and we'll just have to take a step back. We'll read through the lyrics. We'll read through what the song is actually saying and decide, Is this true worship? Is this something that we really want to bring before the church? Or do we just need to table that and go on to something else? This song we're about to do next was one of those songs that we kind of got together. We discussed, the theological portion of it and how does this actually line up. And it was a little tough at first because it's calling God reckless and his love reckless. And you're talking about the creator of the universe here. It seems a little odd to call him reckless, But when you really dig into God's love and the fact that he would leave 99 perfectly good sheep to pursue one, seems a little reckless. But that's just what he does. That's how his grace and his love works. And it seems odd and reckless to us, but oh man, I'm so glad he's so good to us and he loves us that way.
Yeah.
What a truthful song. When you think about your own journey to coming to the understanding of who you are before you found Jesus, how many walls had you built up in your life? How many lies have you told yourself that things are okay? How many mountains have you climbed to get away from the truth of Jesus just because it was uncomfortable to acknowledge that you're a sinner? What a powerful song. And he tears them all down. It's up to us, though, to stop building them walls, huh? Stop finding another mountain range to cross over. Because we're good at that. We can control that. We can work at that and say, look what I did. I just encourage you this morning, if you don't know Jesus, he wants to know you so bad. He's knocking down walls. He's crossing mountain ranges. He loves you so much that he sent his only begotten son to die on a cross in the most horrific way possible just for you. Let's pray this morning. Father, again, we thank you so very much for this time. We thank you for blessing us. We thank you, Lord, for this incredible music. And Lord, as we worship you this morning, we just really pray, Lord, for those hearts that need to be opened, that need to know you, that need to know your love, Lord. We love you, Lord. We say this in your holiest of names. Amen. Got a little out of order. We're going to do the offering now, folks. I just wanted to thank you so much for your giving here at Fellowship Church. It just touched my heart. The song touched my heart, so I wanted to pray about it right away. But this morning's offering is all going to go towards that general fund. Next week's offering will be going towards that the building we're hoping to build out there. Things are moving forward, progressing nicely in that direction. I met with the engineers out here this week. You can sit down, brother. Thank you. Met with the engineers this week and looking at the building, and we've given the plans out, and we're trying to give the plans to some other folks as well in the hopes of getting some numbers back so we can start developing a plan. But the reason why I talk about that is it's because of your giving here at Fellowship Church. We're so very, very blessed to be able to give an entire offering away towards savings so that we can save and build something debt-free to the glory of God. So your offering today, everything you give will go towards taking care of the lights, salaries, paying the water bill, all that good stuff here at the church, as well as things we're able to do for others. So we thank you for your giving this morning. We love you and appreciate you. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Miss Karen. Yeah, now that I should probably thank the band and everybody again. On Tuesday, we actually had a recital in here. And there's a music school in town that has a bunch of little kids, and it's an awesome, awesome outreach to the folks. And again, it's one of those things we don't charge a dime for. And they have people come in from all over the place to see their grandkids play up on stage. It's really, really, really neat. So I do owe an apology and a thanks because I had to like rearranged everything. So they had to come in here and redo. And like the cleaning crew on Wednesday were in here vacuuming like piles of glitter because little kids love glitter. You know, that's just the way it goes. But again, we're thankful that you're here. This morning, you're in for a very, very special message from Christopher Brooks. Awesome guy. If you haven't met him yet, you got to approach him at some point and just shake his hand. You're not going to meet a better guy. He sincerely is a great, great person. I love him to death. He's a brother in Christ, and he's closer than a brother here on earth, that's for sure. And you all are in for a treat on a message about love from a man who knows how to do it. So I lost me and got you. Hey, please do us a favor. Give a round of applause for Mr. Christopher Brooks.
Well, good morning, church. How y'all doing? Thanks for being in the house today. Just want to thank all y'all for coming out. Just tell you I love you guys. I really do. I feel like I'm talking to my family up here. And online, good morning. I love all you that are tuning in. My family that's at home. Just our snowbirds that have gone back home that are tuning in this morning. We just love you guys. I just thank y'all for being in church with us today. We're going to dig in today a little bit into God's love. I did a lot of study and I thought I knew what I was going to speak on. But as the more I studied and prayed and God just kind of melded into what he wanted, I'm assuming here. So here at Fellowship Church, we love Jesus and we love people. We say that every week. We love people. We love Jesus. That's our motto. And I just kind of want to dig into that a little bit today. Because it seems that loving Jesus seems to be the easier part of that. Right? He died for us. He loved us first. How hard is that to love back? Somebody who loves you first? It's easy to love somebody back. He died for us. He gave himself up to pay the price for our sins because he wants to spend eternity with us. How hard is that to love? That's pretty easy. Somebody who would give up everything to just come down and sacrifice himself to be able to spend eternity with the people that he loves, that's pretty easy to love back. And they tried to trick Jesus in his words a lot. The religious muckety-muck of the day were always trying to trip him up in his words and trying to catch him up. And there were 613. I always thought it was just the Ten Commandments. We start talking about the old law and hang all these on the law. There's 613 Old Testament laws. And when Jesus was asked what the greatest was, he quoted Deuteronomy 6:5. And Leviticus 19:18. And in Deuteronomy, it says you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your might. That's the greatest. And the second one is likened unto that one. In Leviticus, don't take vengeance or bear a grudge against the sons of your own people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. So Jesus told us also to love our neighbor. That's the hard part, because we're talking about sinners. We're talking about people, and people be peopling out there, and that's sometimes kind of hard to love. We're hard-headed, we're stubborn, we're irritable, and that's kind of a challenge, is to love people, right? Like I said, loving Jesus seems to be the easy part. Just getting out there and loving a lost and dying and sinful world seems to be the challenge. Now, in my life, I've been blessed to have some great examples of what God's love for people looks like. When we were growing up, we would go, me, my cousins, my brothers, whatever, we would go to our grandparents' house for the summer. and spend time, about a week during the summer, and spend time with them. And there was a little widow lady that lived not far named Miss Sally. And she would always send us over to her house to wash her car or help her clean up around the yard and just really love and serve this lady. And we didn't know. We were kids, you know. We didn't really realize how we were portraying Christ's love for my grandparents', you know, neighbors there. You know, my granddad was on the board for the Habitat for Humanity, and we were always working in somebody else's house, somebody we didn't even know, you know, either running wire or hooking up an AC unit or doing whatever needed to be done on a construction site for the community, for people who needed housing through the Habitat for Humanity. Also, my dad, my father, some of y'all met him here. He prayed over the offering when he was here. My dad has been a fine example of unconditional love. I can't tell you how many times growing up, we, for nothing, would go and help somebody. Somebody on the side of the road, go pick them up, take them to the tire store, buy them a tire, go back to their car, put the tire on for them, and don't ask them for a dime. Same thing, growing up, I didn't know this was my dad's way of showing me what Christ's love is supposed to look like. It's a sacrificial thing. You give up your time. You give up what you have. Make yourself maybe a little uncomfortable to go out and love and do for somebody else. So it's an action. It's something that you can see. It's tangible. So we're going to dig into that, and hopefully God speaks through me and touches you guys like he did me in this study this week. So, because we're talking about love, we're going to get into the love chapter, 1 Corinthians 13, 1 through 3. And let's just try to build the case here for love and its importance. It says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels and have not love, I'm a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and I understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but I have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, deliver up my body to be burned, and have not love, I gain nothing." So if I speak in tongues, if I deliver the best gospel message that's ever been preached, if I prophesy, if I do all these great things, if I understand all mysteries, but I don't love, I am nothing, I gain nothing. Nothing. You're a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. That's how the pagans used to worship, by the way. Just make a bunch of loud noises, a bunch of murmurs that made no sense whatsoever. So you're basically imitating a pagan when you're just making noise for the sake of noise. And there's no love involved. So without love, I gain nothing and I am nothing. That's pretty strong words right there. So let's talk about what love is and what love ain't. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It's not arrogant. It's not rude. It does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. That's a pretty good list right there, and you can take that to the bank with any aspect of your life, whether it's with your wife, with your kids, with your employees, your employer, your church family, the lady at the grocery store. You can check the love list right here on verse 4 through 7. So love is patient. It's kind. And these are the things that I'm telling you are difficult to be with people. It's hard to be patient and kind with people a lot of times, because if you're anything like me, they're pretty hard-headed, and it's hard to be patient and kind with them. Amen. So love is rejoicing in the truth. It's carrying. It's believing. It's hoping and enduring. Patient also in the King James says long-suffering. That's an interesting translation to me, because that just tells you right there your love is expected to be sacrificial. Long-suffering, you got to suffer with somebody to show them your love? Yes, yes. Jesus suffered the ultimate to show us his love. So for us to just suffer long with somebody, be a little bit more patient, a little bit more kind with somebody, that shouldn't be as challenging as it is. But with him in our hearts and him guiding us and us going through his word and his way, it makes it a little easier. So let's also talk about what love ain't. We see what love is. Love ain't envying. It's not boasting. You're not puffed up, proud of yourself. It's not arrogant. It's not rude. It's not insistent on its own way. Love's not irritable or resentful. And it doesn't rejoice for wrong. Now this week, as I'm studying this, God kind of checked my heart. Chris Brooks, how good are you doing on that list? Are you patient and kind? Do you rejoice in the truth? Are you caring, believing, hoping, enduring? I think I'm doing a pretty good job in the world. I do all right. How about at home? Am I patient and kind with my wife? Am I hoping and enduring with my children? Or am I envying and boasting and arrogant and rude and insisting on my way? Tell y'all guys, if I'm being honest, I got a big F on that list. I could be doing a lot better. I get home from work sometimes and I talk to my wife like she's one of the guys on the job site. That's not very patient. That's not very kind. Same with my children. I want it. It's my house. It's my way. Right? I could do a lot better than that. They deserve better than that. And this list can be taken, like I said, out into the world, any aspect of your life. Maybe check your heart. How good are you guys doing? And then it gets to this beautiful phrase, love never ends. All these spiritual gifts, all these things that Paul talks about leading up to this part of the chapter, he says they'll all pass away. Prophecies, tongues, they will cease. Knowledge, it'll pass away. For now we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, that partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up my childish ways. That love ain't list are all childish characteristics. Anybody who has kids or who has raised kids can attest to that. They have to have things their way. They're rude. They're impatient. I love my kids. I don't want to sit up here and bash my kids, but anybody who's a parent knows that I'm telling the truth. It's childish. When I demand to have my way, I'm being childish. When I'm not kind or patient with my town or my people or my family, I'm not being a man. I'm being childish. Those are childish things. So when love brings us to that maturity, we put away those childish things and we tap into that what love is list. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide. Those are pretty good things. Faith, hope, and love abide. Paul says the greatest of these three is love. So let's talk about faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Faith is the complete trust or confidence in someone or something.
faith. That's huge. That's huge to the believer. That's huge to our relationship with God. Our faith is a huge thing. Paul says love is greater than that. How about hope? It's a confident expectation and a desire for a certain thing to happen. This hope. That's huge. Hope for a better future. Hope for when Jesus comes back. Paul says love is greater than that. Love can be described as like a feeling, an emotion, a warm attachment. I don't think that's the type of love that Jesus was telling us to have for our neighbor. I don't think that's the type of love that Paul was talking about when he wrote this letter to the Corinthians. It's over and over an example of a sacrifice, a sacrificial love, an action, something that we live out in our day-to-day lives. John 13:35 says, "By this all people will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another." People can't see my warm attachments to my brothers and sisters. People can't see my warm affections for my wife or my family. It's an action. I have to be living it out. I have to be stepping it out. I have to be showing it in my day-to-day, everyday, mundane things. I have to approach those things with love. That means I'm going to have to sacrifice some of my own time. I'm not going to get my way every time I want it to be my way. I'm not going to remember things that people have done wrong to me. I'm not going to keep a record of that, but I'm going to keep going and loving them through it anyway, through my actions and my deeds. Little children, let us not love in word or talk, but in deed and in truth. There's more proof right there that it's not just a feeling. It's not just a word. It's so easy to just look at somebody and say, "Oh, I love you. I love you too." But do they know it by our actions, or do they just know it by our words? Is it in deed or in truth? Or is it just lip service? We've been called to love our neighbors as ourselves. And it's not just lip service, guys. Jesus sacrificed it all. He gave up his position in heaven to humble himself as a man and show us what true sacrificial love looks like. He gave up his life. He laid down his life for us so we could spend eternity with him. So let's not just talk about it. Let's not just talk about this love. Let's be about it. Let's show the world what Christ's love actually looks like, because they can't just see how you feel on the inside. They can't see your warm affection you may have for them. Now, in this study... You know, I talked about loving my wife. Peter said, "Husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for it." That's sacrificial love I'm supposed to show my wife. Parents, raise your children up in the way they should go, and they won't depart from it. Love your children. Honor your mother and father. That's loving your parents. That's all just in your household. Jesus ate with tax collectors and sinners. And as he went, he loved the least of people. So if you were going along your day and you come across a homeless person, a derelict, a prostitute, a sinner, a drug addict, what's going to be your reaction? Are you going to show them love? Are you going to turn away and say, "No, I'm just going to love my family and my church and people in my closest inner circle that really, you know, can do something for me, that can love me back"? That's not what we've been called to do. Love your neighbor as yourself. Guys, there's a lost and dying, hurting world out there that needs Christ's love. and they're not going to see it on the news. They're not going to see it in their everyday life unless one of the followers of Christ reveals to them his love. And guys, I think we can do it. I know we can do it. I've seen how this church loves people. I've seen this, how this church serves people. I've seen how you guys get out there and don't mind getting dirty. It's a beautiful thing we have here, and it's all because of him. It's all because he loved us first. So let's love Jesus. Let's love people. Let's sacrifice a little bit of our time, a little bit of ourselves to help others. Jesus sacrificed for us and then told us to love our neighbor so we could bring them to salvation through our sacrifice for them. That's how that works. So let's not stop the chain with us, guys. Let's keep it going. Let's continue to love folks. Let's continue to just do for people. Even if it's a smile, a kind word, a hug, encouragement. It's little things. It doesn't have to be anything big. It doesn't have to be some grand movement that you have to do for somebody. It's the little things. People really see your love for them in the details. So, if anybody here doesn't know that Jesus loves them that way or has never accepted Christ's love, and you're sitting here today and you're like, wow, that sounds pretty good, you know, that somebody would humble themselves enough to make themselves a man and come and die for me for the things that I've done wrong. If you don't know that, I'd like to give you the opportunity this morning to accept his love. Just like we sang out today. There's no lie he won't break down. There's no wall he won't kick down. He's constantly pursuing you. He stands at the door and knocks, and all you have to do is open that door and he'll come in and sup with you. So if you'd like to get to know him a little better, you'd like to give your heart to him this morning, I'd like to lead you guys in a prayer. If you could just bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for a great day. God, we thank you for your truth and your love and your grace. God, I just ask that anyone here that doesn't know you, Lord, that you're pricking their heart. Lord, and let us remember that we can't do it on our own. We're not good enough, Lord, but you are. And all we have to do is accept that sacrifice on our behalf. Father, we thank you. God, and we ask everything in the name of your Son. With every eyes closed in the house and your heads bowed this morning, if you haven't accepted him as your Lord and Savior, I'd like to lead you in a prayer today. It's easy as acceptance of that gift that he gives you of salvation, believing that he died for you. He died on that cross. He rose again on that third day, and choosing to turn away from your old life and stepping into the life he has for you. So can I lead you in that prayer this morning? Dear Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I know I have sinned against you. God, and I'm asking you to forgive me for that today. And Jesus, I don't understand how all this is going to work. I don't understand what's going on inside of me right now. But I want you to know that the best way I know how, I want to put my faith and my trust in you. Lord, your word says if I confess with my mouth Jesus and I believe in my heart that you died and you raised from the dead for me, that I shall be saved. God, and I'm believing that this morning. I'm accepting your word. I'm accepting your gift. And Jesus, I just ask that you come into my heart and you live through me. In Jesus' name, amen. And guys, if you said that prayer this morning, I just want to welcome you to the kingdom, welcome you to the family. If you need somebody to pray with, somebody to talk to, there's lots of us in and around this room. You can come down. I'll wait down front to pray with you and talk to you. And I'd love to see you in church again next week. Guys, we love you. We thank you so much for being here. Appreciate all your support. You know, I get to stand up in front of you guys this morning like I'm speaking to my family. There's my aunts, my uncles, my cousins, my brothers in here. You guys are all family. And I really appreciate your love and your support of me and my family. And I just hope you guys have a great week. Let's get out there. Let's be about it, guys. Let's love people. Amen. God bless you guys. Have a great week.
Thank you, brother. Thank you so much. We love you. God bless you all. Have an amazing week. Please don't forget to sign up for some stuff on the way out for the luncheon and all that good stuff. And like Brother Chris said, if you have any questions about what he talked about this morning, come on down. You can talk to Chris. You can talk to Brother Kyle up here. We'd love to plug you in somewhere. We love and appreciate you. God bless you all. Pastor Gary will be back next week with a new message. God bless you.